Welcome back to Leaf's Odyssey. I'm now playing version 1.0.6, which apparently over the past few days, Alex did manage to figure out the keyboard repeat problem, which apparently had something to do with the gamepad polling code. So I'll certainly take his word for it that it's fixed. I'm sure he did a lot of testing off camera to make sure that worked correctly. So, fingers crossed, that should be a worry of the past. Leaf has had a good rest. Let's get going. So, definitely going to need to think a lot more carefully about how to combine tactics that I had to work out in all of these prior rooms we went through. Look at all this glorious landscape behind us. Gotta put them all together in all these advanced rooms we're going to. All of that is just going to be a matter of fact. So, destroy all the enemies and leave the room. This looks like the equivalent of a one-way passageway. I definitely like how we're reusing a lot of elements to create, we're not going to add a force arrow to the game, we're just going to reuse pressure plates and doors to, and just clever level design to get what we need here. So it looks like this might be an area where I can enter it 3 times, do some business in here, circle back around, and then try again. My guess is, the way this is set up, I probably want all 3 of these doors to be held down, or rather, open. So kill that, hold that down, and also hold that, well, free that, but also don't drop that angry eye. I wonder how that's going to work. Yeah, because if that pressure plate ever opens, that's going to die, and I certainly don't want that. Do I have a way of blowing that up? Remotely? I guess the eye could do it. So, I think now I know what I need you for, so let's get started with something that seems like a good start. We'll just see where that goes. We'll see where that takes us. You're also a problem. Hang on. I can't exactly have this thing following one tile behind me, going over here, if this thing is also after me. So, I mean, sure, I could start with something like this. But, yeah, now we're just having problems. I don't have time to kill you. I don't really have anywhere I could stash you, either. Like, maybe I could waste a bit of time here. Yeah, that's no good. Don't want that. And I can't get past you, so maybe this is the wrong one to start with, then. What if I started down here? Yeah, because notably I have a little bit more room. There's 2 rows here, but there's only 1 row here. That might matter. So sure. That means I can do that. And I could bring you along. But then I still can't really bring you past that eye. That's not happening. Not unless I get you on this column already. Via some other means. So, like, I think I need to have you, like, follow along here. Oh, but even, like, 1 turn earlier than that, even. Yeah, something like that. Yeah, I had enough space to do that. And now you're alongside me so we can cross the eyes together. That seems like a good start. So that takes care of that. If I had rubble right there, that'd be excellent. And then if you were dead, that would also be excellent. So here's a theory. I could do this at any time. Like, I did have to do a little bit of wiggling to worry about you, but the rest of this whole thing is kind of like state independent. It doesn't matter which iteration of the room I'm on. So how about I leave that snake alone? It's fine where it is. This might actually just be a puzzle about which row I need to use when. In which case, I might want to save this for later. So maybe I think I want to do this to take care of you, this to take care of you here, and then this, I bet, is going to be helpful for taking care of you. Having cover on this row seems like a good idea. So that leaves you being kind of the leftover. So that just gets used like that. I think that's enough for this iteration. I don't need to do anything else special here. Come back, do it all over again. Yeah, I'm starting to get used to, slowly but steadily, figuring out how to make these turn corners and be on the correct side of me for operations later on in the room. It'll still take some practice, but that sequence of moves makes sense to me now. I definitely would not have been able to do that earlier when I was playing this game in earlier episodes. Alright. Let's get some cover. And because I'm safe from this eye for now, that buys me just enough time to do this whole thing. Okay. I was a little worried jumping right back into advanced puzzles after taking a break for a few days, but I suppose I'm doing alright. Alright, I'm a sneaky ferret. Can't see me in here. Well, I'm gonna need some help, of course. What if these lanes were open? Well, it'd be nice if they could be open and also I could get across there, but can't have those at the same time. Yeah, if I try and go directly for the eyes, this is what'll happen. I'll run out of space. I can't just go backwards. Let's see if statue debris could help me out. Let's find out what happens here. It is cover. So what am I after here? Something like, I need to be able to wake this thing up, step out of view, and then this is how I get around a one-tile obstacle, is this. No, it isn't even that simple. Like, step away, step back, step up. No, I can't even make progress like that. So if I put that there, I'm not getting around it. I don't have enough time. So do I need some sort of cover up here, perhaps? Let's find out what happens. Oh, so the eye can't see me because I guess this is a tall monster, perhaps? That might be the rule. Let's see what the journal has to say about this. Sure. Yep, we saw those in earlier rooms. Angry eye. Dies on hot coals after a turn. Yes, if that ever happens, then yeah, that makes sense. That is normal behavior. And statue drops trapdoors when stepping off them. Okay. So, this might just be a new rule we're learning about in this room, is, tall statues, even while standing up, block eyesight. Can I use that to my benefit? There's gotta be a reason why we have four of these. I could make stepping stones. That's potentially useful. We've just seen how being able to step back and forth and have dry land could be quite nice. So certainly I could put statues on any of these tiles, but in order to do the back and forth steady advancement dance, I want statues to be on one of these tiles. But I don't want a piece of rubble, because that would be in the way, as I just said. So how am I going to get a statue here? Well, these start farther back. What if I do something like... that's not very helpful. Maybe if I can go across solid ground. Like, what if I make this a stepping stone and this a stepping stone? I could get here in time. And sure, I could drop that into water ahead of time. That's not hard. Okay. What about this? I'm gonna need, like, one more stone here, too, but that might be okay. Okay, get you here. Drop that first. Drop it first. Put you here. There. Now, maybe... I don't think this is correct, but I should at least check. Yeah, same problem. I still don't like how this is all jammed up. I think I need more trapdoors to be up, because I think if I had trapdoors, I could go forward. Like, if this was a trapdoor and that was a trapdoor, then things would actually be fine. So I think I need to be careful about how I drop these and in what order. I think I need to use the stepping stones as a base to stand on when I do more work. Yeah, that'll let me get ahead of you. Maybe. I'm not sure how I'm going to put a step here, though. That seems tougher. Maybe you can do that better. But that still doesn't answer the question of how I'm going to put a stone here. I could put one here. That might be enough. Like, sidestep back and forth. I can get past this. That's free, I can get past this. Let's try this shape. Okay, this might be correct. No obstacles. I might only need those squares once, so it might be alright. Yeah. Using a trapdoor lets me go forward, so even if I had, a trapdoor here, that would be alright. Okay. I'm glad that this puzzle is here. This is a very important principle to know for other rooms, because I'm sure this kind of, too-wide hallway is going to show up again. This seems like too useful a widget to only use in one puzzle. Okay, so we've got an immediate problem here. What to do about it? Maybe the eye, maybe the bug can help me out. Or maybe standing on that pressure plate will help me out. These things go counterclockwise, so if I did send a slug this way, slug could hold down the plate for me, get kind of caught here. Trouble is, I don't know how I would kill this eye in the corner, but at least that gives me a possible route to getting a leaf in here to kill this eye. Well, I guess we could just try things and see if they work. I can always change my mind afterwards, huh? There's There's no border on this cracked brick wall, but there is over here. Thus lending possibly some further evidence to the idea that this is a unit, or rather an entity, rather than a piece of wall. Well, we'll see. So, this is straightforward enough. Yeah, that pretty much happens on its own. Not too much that's complicated about this. Okay, explosions don't get rid of poison. You're trapped in there. That could be a problem. Let's do this with the other slug. Just so that I can still get you out at a later time of my own choosing. Oh, interesting. I think I have an idea. I think I know how to solve this problem of there being two poison trails in the way of the, Angry Eye. I think that's what the second slug is for. Well, first, I'm just testing something, so I just want to get that out of the way for now. I might need that later, but, for now, I just want that out of the way. I need to confirm this part. This is important. So I want to step here. I think the problem is, I think the poison processes immediately as part of Leaf's move. I think Alex might have talked about this in one of his earlier commentary videos on the slug portion. Way over here. I think as part of the entity moving onto the tile, it checks whether there's poison there, and if there is, it dies immediately. So I think that's the problem. I need that to just go around the loop once. So I think then that if that charges up and I step on the door, then yes, the door protects me from the eye. I needed to test that first, because if it was the other way around, if that did not work to protect me, then I was going to have to start rethinking some things. But that did seem like the only way that this was ever going to work. And then that's what this little notch is here. That's how I can dodge that. So, thus, this slug clears up this piece of the trail, and this slug clears up this piece of the trail so I can get at the last eye. That's how that works. So, just do it again. I think the bomb bug's job is done once this part is all set. Like, I need to use it here and then get it back and use it for you, but I think that's it. I don't think I need it in here. That was the other thing I was checking, is did I need the bomb bug at the last minute, but I think the answer to that is no. Alright. Good job. Okay. I might have to just move you out of the way a little bit and get you back. How? How will I pull you down there? I guess you're just gonna have to go the long way. Alright. That's fine. Alright, thank you, slug. Oh, that's no good. I don't want that. Okay, we will go the long way this way. Oh, that's no good. But I can take cover behind the door. There we go. And you're on the wrong row, but I can pull you up. There. That should do. Alright, almost, but you can tell what I'm doing. Alright, good enough. I'm not too worried about the phases of these things. It shouldn't matter too much where the positions of these things are relative to one another. I should be able to just take my opportunities where I can get them. But not too soon. Okay, bump, kill, kill, kill. That's good enough. Okay. Makes sense. Honestly, this is not that complicated. It's just putting a whole bunch of parts together from previous rooms. Which is fine. This is an intermediate room. Yeah, this is a pretty long, linear corridor going on here. That's also what was going on this way. I guess it makes sense if you're building a whole bunch of rooms that are building on one another. I think that probably made sense for this sequence. Here, I'm not quite as sure. These are definitely becoming a little bit more complicated, but I don't think these are necessarily as closely related to one another as these puzzles were. Still, I'm glad that none of these are roadblocking me too hard. We'll see if that changes in the future. This looks like just a mess of plates and doors I've got to get through. What's got to go in what order? Ah, that's the problem. Neat that there is a way of kind of remotely producing these obstacles, which is obviously being used kind of, sort of, as a trap this time around, but could be pretty handy for, like, on purpose, using it for my benefit later on. This actually does seem pretty good. Yeah, this is Leaf's route out, actually, so it's good that that's held down. I guess you're going to have to deal with this later, probably once these are dead. Okay. Yeah, because that's trapped back there, so only an eye could ever kill that. Do I still need you alive? Probably not after this is done. Like, after this is done, I probably don't need that. Let's see, so that's sealed off. Yeah, this has to still be alive in order for this part to be done. But once this is killed, then I can do that. Alright, so here's the problem. And yeah, I'll kill you on this side and then get out. The last actual problem of the room, how do I deal with this part? I think I know the answer. It's because I didn't need to do this part yet. If I still have two alive statues, then this statue will block that statue in. So I want this not to happen? How am I going to prevent that from happening? Like so. Just reuse the same trick I learned in an earlier room. That's how these things are done. I know how to make an eye not fire in a direction when I can get close to it. So this will play out the same. This is kind of, I guess you can call it an introduction to... It kind of gets you thinking along the lines of what you need for this part. Oh, but now this is blocked. I guess I might need to make use of this this switch. I guess as long as this is done... Like if I do it like that... Okay, then this is set up and I can do this later. So now I can take care of that while I have the chance. Now I might be able to hit the switch. How am I going to go back? Yeah, because this is still a problem. I still have to figure out how I'm going to get you killed. I guess I need this switch to be on. Yeah, there does not seem to be any downside to hitting the switch now. I can always hit the switch again. Yeah. Yeah, I can always go back here, assuming I can actually make it through. Which, maybe I can, maybe I can't. But that does seem like that will help with getting you here and getting you dead. Which would mean I could kill this, which... Oh, that is still one of the last things I do. Hmm. Maybe that step comes later. Okay, so let's review. So far, what seems like the right course of action is to not do the obvious thing at the start of the room. That's how a lot of these puzzle games go. Don't do the obvious thing. So that gets blocked off. Do this trick. Have two alive statues here. That's important. That's the only way that rubble ever gets put here. Which is important for just getting that dead. Just getting that dead in the first place. But do I need that dead? Maybe I don't. Maybe I don't actually want to kill that there. Because I don't necessarily need that to be open permanently. I just need it to be open long enough for Leaf to walk in here, kill this eye, and walk out. Then after that, it doesn't really matter where these die so long as, so long as that door is still held down. Maybe these could be killed at the end of the room? Like, maybe if one is killed, like, if a rubble is right here, then the other could squeeze through at the very end or something? Maybe. Let's deal with this part. This seems like there's a lot fewer valid solutions to this. Like, these have to be held down to go forward to the next part. There's not really a lot of wiggle room there. So let's get started with that, then. This eye might actually help me hit that switch with good timing, maybe. Yeah, that's a good start. I don't want to kill that yet, and yet it would be really helpful. Let's see what happens here. Oh, it's closed. Hmm. Hmm. So it would be useful if this was dead at this point, but it can't be dead yet because that has to happen later, after this is killed. Okay, what if I kill that now? Then is it okay? This doesn't need to be open anymore, so I kill that now. That gives me slightly better access to this row. Plus, this is no longer looking down here, so now I can just go over here, which is great. To get this killed, the switch has to be in this state. But I can always flip it back. So maybe I just do this now. Oh, but I want you to be on this side of the door, so that's what the eye is for. Okay. Close the door while the statue's on that side. Okay. This is all static now. Don't have to lure any of these out. They're dead. They're dealt with. Don't kill you yet. And now that holds that one in place so this eye can kill it. My way is clear. I think I can just kill all the eyes and leave now. Okay. That's basically how these kinds of rooms tend to go. Takes a lot of experimentation to figure out the consequences, the long-term, subtle consequences of doors being opened and closed. But once you've played around with it for a while, eventually you start realizing what the tactical benefits are of doors being open, doors being closed, why plates are the way they are. Eventually you come to an understanding. It takes a while. You're not gonna know at the very start. You're not gonna see all of this happen in your mind's eye from the minute you walk into the room. But through a process of experimentation and thinking about what needs to go where, when, and in what order, eventually you can untangle this kind of thing. Okay, yeah, what a finale. All right, well, we have a little bit of time left. And yeah, the Canyon Prize. So here's what we could do next. There is advanced slugs and advanced statues still to do. But I am a little bit curious. To get to this point, we did have to effectively solve all the basic areas to get all the Terra keys. But there's only two doors here. Presumably, this is kind of going out on a limb here. Presumably, there are two infernal keys, red keys, at the ends of these segments here and here. But I only need two to go in here, so there is a certain amount of optionalness to the others. Let me take at least a peek down here and see what's involved. Probably not any new elements. I think we've seen all the elements by now, but I just want to see, I guess what this might entail. Oh, well, need another door here. Okay. Never mind. There is another element, but it's not an entity. It's a tile. So I needed two reds to go to any of these places, but I actually needed a third red to go here. And I assume I'll also need a red here. Yep. Okay. So new elements entirely. I have a choice as to whether I want to get started with those once I've gotten the third red key, or if I just want to go ahead and get that fourth red key. But regardless, question asked and answered. Can't do any of that until I get a red third key. Yes. So, no matter what, gotta stay the course. At least this much longer. This isn't too far out of my way. I could have teleported, but this is not a far walk. Look, we're here already. Alright, advanced slugs. I had a bit of trouble with this earlier part, but it seemed a bit smaller than the rest. Although, maybe that might just be there was a mixture of... To me, this whole segment here felt like a mixture of easy rooms and really, really diabolically tough ones, whereas the rest ones felt like a lot more even and average, more smoothed out among all of them. So we'll see how this treats me. There's at least five in here, and if this segment is any indication, it could be at least six, possibly even longer. Who knows? So, not planning on making it through yet, but we'll see. Well, this is, more eyes than is strictly necessary. This is going to be very silly. Well, I could get that eye killed. Interesting. This actually does show up in the analysis. I guess it's there so that, if the eye was dead, then the eye beam start would still be there as a separate entity. Yeah, that makes a certain degree of sense. So, obviously if I try and go up this way, we're gonna start killing some stuff. If I time this right, it'd be very convenient if I could kill that, but it's not going to be that easy. It's probably alright if that one dies, though. Like, if this slug is safely down here, which I can do if my timing is right. Yeah, so now that one's safely out of the way, it's okay that these are dead. That one's on course to go up here. And this one's safe. So I have a brief time limit in which I could cross over here. Maybe I just want to kill this eye. Do a little bit of a dance here. And just make the path clear. I should be able to get that one. I think I can kill the rest of these. Okay. Not so bad. A very deadly room of death. Very dangerous room, this one, but I appreciate being able to just send the slugs straight to where they needed to go. This seemed like a room where, if I had done anything other than that, it would have gotten horribly messy. Like, if slugs got on the border here, just no way I could clean that up after that, with how dangerous and specific everything was. There had to be a direct solution, and indeed, there was. Okay, I've definitely seen this kind of puzzle before. However, okay, I can place one obstacle wherever I want. So this goes in a counterclockwise circle. Don't want it to go there. Do definitely want it to go here. So that means I needed to run into some kind of obstacle on the east side here. It could be this, or it could be debris. And then eventually, go up this way. And I can toggle the doors such that that happens, I think. Although I'm not so sure if this will work. Hang on. I don't know if I can make the slug cross over that. Let's do a science experiment. Okay, it's queuing a move. Does it move off of this in time, or do I just immediately drop it in the water? Okay, it does move off. So I don't know what to infer about that. I don't know if that means that the switch gets hit and only activates at the end of the turn or something. Or if slugs get a chance to move off of something. Or does any entity get a chance to move off of something before it drowns? In this room, Leaf moved first and the slug moved afterwards. So whenever the case was that Leaf didn't move, like Leaf spent their turn not moving, and then the floor opened up underneath them, at the end of the turn, Leaf drowned, of course, because after all that was said and done, Leaf was on water, and thus as a result, Leaf drowned. I don't think I had a lot of chances to test that. This might have been a room where I could have tested that. Haven't really been able to check that with other enemies yet, I think. Just hasn't come up yet. So, I think that's question asked and answered. I could have the slug cross this with good timing. So, there's a lot of places I could put this, and I just have to figure out where exactly I want this. Technically, opening up the floor and then making a stepping stone under there is also a possibility, but it seems silly. That's a good trick to remember for later, but I don't think I need it now. Also, I could just walk in there. I could just walk in there with the slug on the loose. Yeah, there's no rule that says I can't do that. This would be a great place for that statue rubble, but I'm not going to get it there. I think here seems better. Okay, good. So now you'll go up there and we're all done. Wait. Oh, I've got to hurry. Hold on. So I need to lure it off of that, but I've got a long way to go from hitting this switch. Well, let's just see if I'm in time. No, I am not. No, that is a problem. That might mean that this is being ruled out. Like, this seems to be saying to me, the slug has to be in motion without the controls being touched for a long time. Leaf has to go all the way up here, move that and then open that up. So that's the simple solution. I think that's just been ruled out. I'm gonna have to come up with something better. A longer runway for the slug to move down without me directly at the controls. I guess I could always open the door and then immediately run up here. Just then assuming that the slug has a direct path, like, all the way to where it needs to go. Which might be a big ask. Yeah, it seems more likely I'm gonna have to toggle this and leave the slug somewhere in the middle and then eventually make it go up there. So, I was making use of this because it was already in the right place. What if I do something else? So, I'm gonna have to kind of move forward here. This is one of those cases where I just kind of have to think about kind of a breadth-first search of how are all the paths that the slug could follow going to work. Going here is not very exciting. And I could always put a debris here. But then how would I get the slug to go into it? If I put a debris here, I could make the slug go up, left, down, over, and hit that, but that's not any better as far as this switch problem is concerned. That doesn't make this part any better with regards to you. If a slug turns down, it could run into an obstacle here and then go east and then up. So if it ever is in a situation where it goes across the top, hits an obstacle, goes east, hits a different obstacle, it could go up. But I need two obstacles for that. I don't think this is the style of room where I could reuse the statue twice. That would be helpful, but it seems kind of awkward to work with. So let's see, what else can I do? I can open and close that door again. It's not very helpful. If the statue ever comes out here, there's not really much point in that. I don't think I can make you move early with the way this is set up. Nothing else can hit the switch while I'm in here. It seems like that's the only way this is ever going to go north, is if it hits an obstacle here, and assuming that Leaf is not at the controls, that seems to imply it should be going east from one of these two rows. East, hit an obstacle, go north. But how would I make it hit an obstacle here? So that I could make it go east here in the first place. Well, let's at least see what trying to make use of this statue would look like. Right, of course, that's not the right way set up. I do find it very interesting that Leaf does have to go in here to wake this up and then come back out. And I'm pretty sure the reason why these are two, they're made of two trapdoors is just that I can't build a stepping stone to cheat and come back. Not going to be that easy. Well, was it possible for the slug to get on this row without any issues? How did I make it go here? I made it go here and I bumped into something here. That's right. I put the statue here so that it would turn down then that way. So I was just wondering if this was useful to make this, a nice runway path. But I don't think that helps much. Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. It can go up, then down. If I blocked that, then it could go up and then down, hit that, then come down and hit that. Okay, I think I get it. I think I understand now. I was just missing that this could go all the way down, because this is an obstacle and that can make this left turn happen. Yeah, slugs always turn left. I should remember that. That seems to be easier for me to remember than counterclockwise. Slugs always turn left. So I think the tile I need to kill this on is actually this one. This needs to toggle between open and closed. This one, it's okay if it's always open. Well, traversable. But I need to time this better. That's fine. It will come back. Okay, behold. The slug's journey. The slug's odyssey. Go that way. Make use of the fact that that's a pit. Start going this way, cross that, then go here, and this should give me a longer runway. So as soon as it hits that, the way is clear, that will open up in front of it, and I have a longer way, more time for Leaf to get up here. So that is open, and, well, it's there. In time. Okay. Definitely one of the more complicated solutions that there could have been to something like this. But it made sense. The way I arrived at that was purely because nothing easier could have worked. So it had to be something harder. That way of thinking doesn't always work, but it is nice when it actually does work. Well, with good timing, I could make this go wherever I need it to go. I could certainly make a turn left, and I could certainly make a turn left again. But how would I make it turn left here? I think I know how. Alright, I know exactly what to do. We'll use a slug as a baseboard. With good timing, of course. How am I going to push that downwards? No, I don't need to push it downwards. I can stay right here. Here's good. Here's a great spot for it. Perfect. That's exactly where I want you. The slug is going to run into a block on this row, turn here, and hit that. Again, this was the only thing that could possibly work. I know what the end of this has to look like. It has to hit an obstacle in this column and go north. How do I get an obstacle in that column? Oh, it has to be something like that. Nothing else would work. It's that simple. Problem. I'm out of blocks. I can use one to make this turn left. How am I going to make it turn left again? Oh, I think I know. We'll use, the left edge of the room to make a turn left. Of course. So, I'm gonna put this here. I don't need to go back down here. All I need is to go up here. So right here we'll do. And all I need to do is time this. A little bit better. Okay. Looks good to me. Ah. Well, it was a nice thought. So, I need a block right here, I suppose. Okay, my heart was in the right place, but I'm going to have to be more clever about how I use three blocks to make four turns. Then, can I use the bottom row here? Yeah, the slug isn't just going to walk into the water. Okay, that's fine. That's where the missing block comes from. Okay, yeah. So it's got three... The block has six rows to move, and this has three rows to move, and it also spends a turn waiting, so that's how I'm lining this up. So it needs to turn here, turn somewhere so that it goes down, and then like so. Yeah, it's not... There's not that much to it. So that can just wait right there. That's fine. I don't need to bash the block into it or anything. No. And then, yeah, that kills it. Okay. So, clearly I immediately recognized some of the parts that were correct with this, but you can't take too many shortcuts with this game. You do have to actually check everything. I don't think we've seen yet whether statues are immune to poison, are they? They are made of stone, presumably. Yes. So, stone, that's a pretty common immunity. Stone things being immune to poison. So, I could use you to get you out. I would love, of course, for... the slug to just take a direct path, go here, and then here, and go up. Can I do that? I think so, if I do this right. Maybe not. Maybe. I'm gonna have to reuse this. Because I'll certainly want to use you as a disruption. It might be... This statue goes here, and then the other one goes here, is I think actually the answer. Yeah, I've got just enough time to do it, too. I need to start moving upwards while I have the chance. Movement order is not my friend here. But that works, and that's okay. Cool. Again, another one of those rooms kind of like this one, honestly, where I figured if the... I didn't think anything more complicated than that would work. Like, this was a room where I figured the easy solutions are not working, so it must be a hard solution. This one was one where I figured if the solution is going to be super hard... there's a limit to how well I can manipulate these things, so it actually probably needs to be easy, because, there's so few obstacles in the room with which to run away from these enemies. These are the aggressive ones. So, with only a few extra obstacles, I figured I had to be very, very efficient where I put them. Yeah, so I guess it's just a stylistic choice, like, to not put, like, a slug trap over here or something. Looks like I've got a long way to go. Can I maybe fit this one in? I'll give it a try, but I make no promises about finishing this now. It could be a tough one. Well, I might be able to kill these later. There's a lot of role reversals happening in this game series. Oftentimes you end up using, you know, Monster A to block Monster B, and then in a later room you use Monster B to block Monster A. I guess I'll kill you now. Or maybe not. Maybe I need you to block the eye. Yeah. Maybe I want to be on this row. Okay. Keep you alive. Make it past here. you will eventually press that for just a little while, and you're going to get stuck right here. I have one block up here. What will that be useful for? I guess for starters, hiding from you. Oh, right, of course. Yeah, of course you're not going to go right immediately over there. I guess it's okay if I lure you up here. I might be able to use the block to get back. Is that what this is asking me about? Oh, but the poison is there. Hmm. Yeah, and if I try and put the block here, of course, then... No, I'll have one turn of leeway. What if I do this? Here, look this way. Oh, that's a problem. I can't actually... This is resting right up against this thing's line of sight. So I don't have room to get over here and then come back. It's just going to notice leaf too often for me to rescue the block. Unless I do this. Okay, there we go. That's how I do that with only being visible for one turn. Got it. So now I could put that here. Here. I would very much like it if, this could face east, but also these didn't move. The only way that would be possible is if I could make these face north without this one moving. I might be okay, though, because at this point, I don't need these to survive. They don't play any role in maintaining access to this. I have the block where I need it to be. So why don't I just kill them now? Yeah, you're dead. You're dead. Okay. I thought I might have to go across the bridge one more time, but I figured, wait a minute, I can cut this short. This is permanently held down. I was kind of workshopping some theories where the bug was up here and the slug was pressing this plate, but that ended up being kind of messy, particularly because poison would end up here, but the way this ended up working out was a lot cleaner. Okay, I am not going to push my luck any further. This could be pretty tough, so I'm going to leave this aside. This is going to be a perfect thing to start off with next time.